In this lecture, we can study about the outbreeding devices. What is outbreeding devices? These are the contrivances regarding to cross-pollination. What is contrivances? The contrivances means a condition leads to cross-pollination. That is, outbreeding device means such a devices encourage the cross-pollination but it prevent the self-pollination. Such a condition is called as a outbreeding devices. Why we can increase the cross-pollination but prevent the self-pollination? Because in case of self-pollination, hybrid varieties are not formed and such a varieties are susceptible to diseases or they are not resistant to diseases. Therefore, in case of cross-pollination, the progenies are not weaker, they are not susceptible to diseases and hybrid varieties are formed. Continuous self-pollination leads to inbreeding depression in the progeny. Therefore, cross-pollination is better for hybrid varieties. Therefore, in such outbreeding devices, we can study about the total 6 devices which encourage cross-pollination but prevent self-pollination. म्हणजे सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन थांबवणार आहेत हे डिव्हायसेस आणि ते कशाला इन्करेज करणार आहेत ते क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. द फर्स्ट डिव्हाइस ऑफ आउटब्रीडिंग डिवाइस इज युनिसेक्शुअलिटी और इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज अ डायक्लाइनिस सुद्धा त्याला म्हटलं जातं. दट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ युनिसेक्शुअलिटी. व्हॉट इज युनिसेक्शुअलिटी? द फ्लावर बिअरिंग ओनली वन सेक्स ऑर्गन आयदर मेल फ्लावर और फिमेल फ्लावर. दट इज फ्लावर कंटेन ओनली सेक्स ओनली वन सेक्स ऑर्गन. दट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ युनिसेक्शुअलिटी. एकच सेक्स ऑर्गन असल्यामुळे एकतर अँड्रोशियम तरी असेल फ्लावरमध्ये किंवा गायनोशियम तरी असेल, त्यामुळे दोन्ही सेक्स ऑर्गन एकाच फ्लावरमध्ये नसल्यामुळं वी प्रिव्हेंट द सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन अँड इन्करेज द क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. दे आर टू कंडिशन इन युनिसेक्शुअलिटी फ्लावर. मोनोशियस प्लांट. व्हॉट इज मोनोशियस प्लांट और मोनोशियस फ्लावर? बोथ द फ्लावर्स प्रेझेंट ऑन द सेम प्लांट. फॉर एक्झाम्पल मेज. मेजमध्ये नक्की काय आहे बघा, इन केस ऑफ मेज फ्लावर टॉप फ्लावर इज कॉल्ड एज मेज फ्लावर आणि ते पानाच्या खाचामध्ये जे आपण कणीस बघतोय दीज आर द फिमेल फ्लावर. देअर फॉर सच अ कंडिशन ऑल्सो लीड्स, म्हणजे मेल फ्लावर टॉपला आहे मेजमध्ये आणि फिमेल फ्लावर कणीचे ते पानाच्या खाचेमध्ये असतं. देअर फॉर इट प्रिव्हेंट द सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन, इट लीड्स टू ऑर इट इनकरेज द क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. सेकंड कंडिशन इज कॉल्ड एज अ डायोशियस कंडिशन. व्हॉट इज डायोशियस कंडिशन? मेल फ्लावर इज सेपरेट विच बियर्स द मेल फ्लावर, फिमेल फ्लावर इज सेपरेट विच बियर्स द फिमेल फ्लावर. सच अ कंडिशन इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ डायोशियस प्लांट. मलबेरी एक्झाम्पल आहे मलबेरी अँड सेकंड वन इज अ पपया. पपया म्हणजे तुम्ही बघितलं तर मेल प्लांट वेगळं असतं तेव्हा मेल फ्लावर येतात आणि फिमेल प्लांट वेगळं असतं दॅट बियर द फिमेल फ्लावर. देअर फॉर इट इन्क्रीज द क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन बट प्रिव्हेंट द सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन. सेकंड डिवाइस इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ डायकोगॅमी. व्हॉट इज डायकोगॅमी? इन सच अ केसेस अँड्रोशियम अँड गायनोशियम और स्टिग्मा अँड अँथर नॉट मॅच्युअर ॲट द सेम टाइम. Not mature at the same time, therefore it encourages the cross pollination and prevents self pollination. Dichogamy is divided into two types. First one is called as a protoandry and second one is called as a protogyny. What is protoandry? Androsium is mature earlier than gynosium. Is called as a protoandry. Example is dischlorates of sunflower. Means androsium na kothar mature jale. पण तिथं स्टिग्मा जर मॅच्युअर झाला नसेल अॅनोशियममधला तर इट लीड्स टू एन्करेज द क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन प्रिव्हेंट द सेल्फ पॉलिनेशन. सेकंड वन इज कॉल्ड एज अ प्रोटोगायनी. व्हॉट इज प्रोटोगायनी? गायनोशियम इज मॅच्युअर अर्लियर दॅन अँड्रोशियम. सच अ कंडिशन इज कॉल्ड एज अ प्रोटोगायनी. इट ऑल्सो एन्करेज द क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. एक्झाम्पल इज अ ग्लोरियोस. थर्ड डिवाइस ऑफ युअर आउटब्रीडिंग डिवाइसेस इज प्रीपोटेन्सी. प्रीपोटेन्सी इज अ स्पेशल डिवाइस विच कॅन सी इन द एक्झाम्पल दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ ऍपल प्लांट. What is prepotency? The pollen grains of the another flower, they are continuously or immediately germinate on the stigma rather than the pollen grains of the same flower. म्हणजे त्याच प्लांटवरचे पोलन ग्रेन त्याच स्टिग्मावर लवकरात लवकर जन्मेट व्हायच्या ऐवजी दुसऱ्याच प्लांटचे पोलन ग्रेन जन्मेट होतात त्या स्टिग्मावर. अशा कंडिशनला नाव काय दिले आपण? प्रीपोटेन्सी. एक्झाम्पल आहे ॲपल. फोर्थ डिवाइस इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ हेटरोस्टायलिन. हेटरो मीन्स डिफरंट अँड स्टाईल मीन्स तुम्हाला सगळ्यांना माहिती आहे. पिस्टिल इज डिवायडेड इन थ्री टाईप्स, स्टिग्मा, स्टाईल अँड ओव्हरी. हेटरोस्टाईल इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द लेंथ ऑफ द स्टाईल. इट इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द लेंथ ऑफ द स्टाईल. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड ॲज अ हेटरोमॉर्फी. हेटरोस्टाईल इज क्लिअरली सीन इन द प्लांट दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ प्रिमिला और प्राइम रोज. दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ प्रिमिला और प्राइम रोज. दिस शो द क्लिअरली सीन दॅट द हेटरोस्टाईल. In case of heterostyle, they produce, in case of primula or primrose, they produce 2 to 3 different types of flowers. Diheterostyle and triheterostyle condition are easily seen. It is not explained in our textbook. What is diheterostyle? One flower is with long style and short stamen. Another flower will short style and long stamen. Therefore, in between two plants or two flowers, cross pollination is takes place, because in first flower style is very long. Therefore, pollen grains of same flower is not dusted on the same stigma. In another condition, short style and long stamens, the style is very short, and filament or anther stamens are very long. Therefore, same type of anther contain the pollen grain. They are not dusted on same type of the stigma. Therefore, two condition, that is long style and short stamen. Short style and long stamen, they prevent the self pollination and increase the cross pollination. Another condition is called as a tristyly. Tristyly condition present in the primula and primrose, but triheterostyly condition is variable. Then see, there is a long style, medium style and short style condition. In long style condition, there are medium stamens, short stamens. In case of medium style condition, long stamens, short stamens. In very short style condition, long stamen and medium stamens or short stamens are present. This is about the heterostyly, which encourage the cross pollination and stop the self pollination. What is heteromorphy? Heteromorphy means anther and stigma. That is, suppose this is anther and this is stigma. Anther and stigma present at the both the same level. Anther and stigma, which are present at both the same level, and they carry out the pollination, that is called as a heteromorphy. But they are not present at the same level. Stigma is above, anthers are below the level. Therefore, cross pollination lead and it's stop the self pollination. Fifth device of outbreeding device is called as a hercogamy. An example of hercogamy is caladropagia. आपण लुई म्हणतो. They show pentangular stigma. They show pentangular stigma position at the level of position on the level of pollens or pollen. What is hercogamy? Hercogamy means it is a special type of device which increase the cross pollination, but they stop the self pollination, that is called as a to prevent the self pollination in bisexual flower. Hercogamy condition show in bisexual flower. In such a plant, the physical barrier in between, there is a physical barrier in between stigma and stamen or androecium and gynoecium. There is a physical barrier between, natural and physical barrier between androecium and gynoecium. Therefore, they do not show self pollination and increase the क्रॉस पॉलिनेशन. एक्झाम्पल इज कॅलॅट्रॉपिस पेंडेंगुलर स्टिग्मा. आता ही कंडिशन आपल्याला जर बघायची असेल तर सगळ्यात महत्त्वाचं बघायला पाहिजे व्हॉट इज पॉलिनिया. पॉलिनिया मीन्स अ पोलन ग्रेन्स आर ॲग्रिगेट इन अ सॅकलाइक स्ट्रक्चर, दॅट इज कॉल्ड एज अ पॉलिनिया. सच अ पॉलिनिया इज प्रेझेंट इन द कॅलॅट्रॉपिस फ्लावर. कॅलॅट्रॉपिस फ्लावर इज स्पेशल टाईप ऑफ फ्लावर विच हॅव फाईव्ह अँथर लोब्स विच आर फ्यूज टुगेदर, अँड स्टिग्मा इज प्रेझेंट सेंट्रली बिटवीन द फाईव्ह फ्यूज अँथर अँड सच अ स्टिग्मा. स्टिग्मा इज ट्विन नंबर. Stigma is twin number. Surround the stigma, there is a five anther lobes are there fused together. In between stigma and fused five anther lobe, there present pollinia. What is pollinia? Pollinia is the pollen grains are aggregated to form a sac-like structure, that is called as a pollinia. Such a pollinia attached to the insect leg, that is proboscis. When insect land on the stigma, that is pentangular stigma, such a pollinia attached to the insect proboscis, that is legs, and such an insect carry out such a pollinia to another flower, that is leads to cross pollination. Due to pentangular stigma, it prevents the self pollination and ensure the cross pollination. This device is the self sterility. What is self sterility? There is a genetic mechanism or genetic barrier between same type of pollen grains not germinate on the same species of the stigma, or same species of the pollen grains not germinate on the same species of the stigma. That is called as a genetic incompatibility or genetic sterility. Asa sudha tela mhanle jata. Germination of pollen grain on the stigma of the same flower. Parat ekda vakya baghu. Germination of stigma of the same flower on the same stigma. Germination of stigma of same flower is not germinate on the stigma is not germinate on the same flower, which is called as a tobacco. Example is a tobacco and second one is called as a thia. These are the outbreeding devices present, that is called as a contrivances of cross pollination. Let's study about the pollen pistil interaction. Pollen pistil interaction is most important to carry out the fertilization. आपण आतापर्यंत जो भाग बघतोय इट इज गोइंग अंडर द प्री फर्टिलायझेशन चेंजेस. Then last point is undergo, that is called as a pre-fertilization change is pollen pistil interaction. What is pollen pistil interaction? Therefore, we study the pollen pistil pollen and pistil interaction. Pollen pistil interaction. This is the pollen pistil interaction. Why pistil? What is the pistil? Pistil is nothing but the, these are the carpel. Gynoecium divide into three parts, stigma, style and ovary, which is called as a carpel, and such a carpel is called as a pistil interaction. Pollen pistil interaction is most important in sexual reproduction of flower or angiosperm. It is also most important for seed formation. Pollen grains with the sporophytic tissue, that is a interaction between or interaction of pollen grain with sporophytic tissue, that is called as a stigma. Pollen grain ची interaction जेव्हा sporophytic tissue म्हणजे stigma बरोबर होते ती interaction आपल्याला कुठे बघायची, that is pollen pistil interaction मध्ये आपल्याला ती बघायची. It begins with the pollination and ends with the fertilization. ही प्रक्रिया नेमकी कुठे होते? It begins with the pollination and ends with the fertilization. What is pollen pistil interaction? All the events from the deposition of pollen grain on the stigma, then stigma produce stigma, pollen grain produce pollen tube, such a pollen tube pass from stigma, style and ovary. All such events is collectively called as a pollen pistil interaction. Finally, such a pollen tube is attached to the ovule and leads to fertilization. तर आज आपण डायग्रामच्या मार्फत बघणार आहे की नेमकं पोलन पिशल इंटरॅक्शन म्हणजे काय. सपोज दिस इज अ स्टिग्मा, सपोज दिस इज द स्टिग्मॅटिक सर्फेस. सच अ स्टिग्मा शो स्टाईल, स्टाईल इज कनेक्टेड विथ द देन ओव्हरी. दिस इज द सिंगल पिस्टिल, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ सिंगल पिस्टिल आपण त्याला म्हणूया. इट इज अ सिंगल पिस्टिल वेन आता काय होते, वेन पोलन ग्रेन्स इन लँड ऑन द स्टिग्मा after pollination, or pollen is dusted on the stigma after pollination. The cross pollination not chances to deposit the right type of pollen grain on right type of the stigma. When right type of pollen grain is called as a compatible pollen grain. It is called as a compatible pollen grain. In due to cross pollination, only right type of pollen grain is deposited on the right type of the stigma. Such a right type of pollen grain is called as a compatible pollen grain. Such a compatible pollen grain accepted by stigma. When they accepted by stigma, stigma contain water and sugary substance which absorb by the pollen grain, मागे बघितले, which absorb by the pollen grain. When content of the pollen grain is increases inside the content of the cytoplasm, content of the cytoplasm is increases, such a pressure is created on, such a pressure is created on one of the germ pore, and in time is come out from one of the germ pore which is called as a pollen tube. Let's see again. After pollination, the pollen grain is two-celled or three-celled which are deposited on the stigma. When right or type of pollen grain, that is compatible pollen grain, deposited on the stigma, this will accept it. After accepted, water and sugary substance present on the surface of the stigma, it is absorbed by pollen grain. Therefore, cytoplasm content of the pollen grain increases. Such a pressure is created on the intine, and intine come out one of the germ pore which is called as a pollen tube. When pollen tube is elongate and there all the content of the pollen grain is pushes inside the pollen tube which contain the single tube nucleus, which contain the single tube nucleus. Second one is called as a generative cell. Second one is called as a generative cell or generative nucleus. Such a generative nucleus divide by mitosis and to form two male gametes. That is, two haploid non-motile male gametes are formed. Therefore, pollen tube contain, at the tip of the pollen tube, tube nucleus is present. Two haploid non-motile male gametes are present and cytoplasm is also covered in the pollen tube. Inside the ovary, ovule is present. Inside the ovary, ovule is present. The special type of ovule present in the angiospermic plant, we can already study, that is called as an anatropous ovule. In such an anatropous ovule, they show outer two integument and inner, outer integument and inner integument. The outer integument and inner integument is called as a bitegmic ovule. Therefore, such a type of structure is present inside the ovary. This is the ovule, that is anatropous ovule, which have chalazal end, antipodal cells are present, and micropylar end, eight and two lateral synergids are present. This is the structure of anatropous ovule. These are the antipodal cells, right? Antipodals. They are also called as antipodals. In the center of such a ovule or embryo sac, there is a secondary nucleus is present. Secondary nucleus is also present at the center of the embryo sac, and this is the seven-celled and eight-nucleated embryo sac. Seven-celled and eight-nucleated embryo sac. Such a pollen tube is attracted towards the ovule. Why attract towards the ovule? Because ovules or ovary show some special chemical substance which attract the pollen tube towards the ovary. Such an attraction of pollen tube towards the ovary is called as a chemotactic movement. Therefore, pollen tube is elongated. Such a pollen tube is elongated and enter through the micropylar end inside the ovule. Therefore, pollen tube is elongated. They pass from stigmatic tissue, styler tissue, and then enter inside the ovary. They enter inside the ovule through micropylar end. Through micropylar end. When micropylar end attract the pollen tube towards the micropylar end, at the base of the synergy, the special type of the structure or cells are present. We can study in last lecture, that is called as a filiform apparatus. At the base of the synergy, आपण डायग्राम मध्ये इनलार्ज करू अप्लाय करण्यासाठी परत एकदा. At the base of the synergy, there is specialized the cells are present, which is called as a filiform apparatus. Suppose this is an embryo sac. मी एकच embryo sac इथे काढली आहे. They have micropylar end, large egg and small synergids. At the base of the synergids, there is a finger-like projections, two finger-like or pair of finger-like projection is present, which is called as a filiform apparatus. This is called as a egg. Then chalazal end, there is a chalazal end which show the antipodal cells. Antipodal cells are present. These are the three antipodal cells are present. Then centrally placed a diploid secondary nucleus is present. Secondary nucleus is present. This is the micropylar end covered by two integument. When pollen tube enters through micropylar end and touches to the embryo sac, at the same time, therefore, two male gametes and tube nucleus is also present in the pollen tube. Such a pollen tube touches to the embryo sac. Filiform apparatus attracts the pollen tube toward the egg. Therefore, such a pollen tube enters inside the embryo sac by bursting the one of the synergid. And such a synergid contain the water. Which is absorbed by pollen tube. Therefore, water content inside the pollen tube tip increases and tip of the pollen tube is burst. At the same time, tube nucleus is degenerate and they release, pollen tube release the two male gametes in the embryo sac. First male gamete fuses with the egg to form diploid zygote, and second male gamete fuses with the secondary nucleus to form primary triploid endosperm tissue, or diploid primary endosperm tissue is formed. All such events is called as a pollen fission interaction. It is only possible in compatible pollen grains. When compatible pollen grain land on the compatible stigma, they still accept it. But in another condition, when wrong type of pollen grain deposited on the stigma, they still reject it, because in between interaction between stigma and pollen grain contains specific chemical composition. Therefore, stigma, the compatible pollen grain is accept and incompatible pollen grain is released or they are rejected. Incompatible pollen grain means wrong pollen grain. Such a wrong pollen grain is rejected by stigma. Therefore, the germination of pollen grain on the stigma is not possible and fertilization is not takes place. म्हणजे आपल्याला तो काय बघायचं आहे की रॉंग टाइप्स ऑफ द पोलन ग्रेन डिपॉझिट झाला स्टिग्मावर तर हे पोलिनेशन किंवा पोलन जनरेशन घडणार नाही. पण कॉम्पॅटिबल पोलन ग्रेन किंवा राईट टाईप ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन जर स्टिग्मावर येऊन पडले, पिसिल ॲक्सेप्ट इट, रॉंग टाईपचे पडले तर पिसिल रिजेक्ट करणार आहे. व्हाय दिस ॲक्सेप्टन्स अँड रिजेक्शन इज रिकग्नाइज बाय स्टिग्मा, बिकॉज सम केमिकल कंपोजिशन प्रेझेंट इन द पोलन ग्रेन, देअर फॉर सच अ केमिकल सबस्टन्स प्रेझेंट द पोलन ग्रेन ड्यू टू केमिकल कंपोजिशन, स्टिग्मा ॲक्सेप्ट द राईट टाईप ऑफ द स्टिग्मा दॅट इज कॉम्पॅटिबल पोलन ग्रेन अँड रिजेक्ट द रॉंग टाईप ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन ऑर इनकॉम्पॅटिबल पोलन ग्रेन्स. इन प्लांट सच अ पोलन पिशल इंटरॅक्शन प्ले इम्पॉर्टंट रोल इन सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन अँड सीड फॉर्मेशन. पोलोलन कॅन बी ऑल्सो जर्मिनेट ऑर इंड्यूस आर्टिफिशियली बाय युझिंग द सुक्रोज सोल्युशन. वी कॅन यूज द सुक्रोज सोल्युशन टू जर्मिनेट टू पोलन ग्रेन. पोलन ट्यूब इज कम आउट वन ऑफ द जर्म पोर अँड ऍडिशन ऑफ बोरिक ॲसिड इट फॅसिलेट द अँड ॲक्सिलेट द पोलन जर्मिनेशन. हे झालं आपण पोलन पिशल इंटरॅक्शनच्या बाबतीत बघत होतो. आत्ताचे आपण बघितले की आर्टिफिशियली पोलन ट्यूब तयार करणं पोलन ग्रेनला किंवा बोरिक ॲसिड ॲड करून, त्यालाच आपण इथून पुढे बनणार आहे आर्टिफिशियल हायब्रिडायझेशन. व्हॉट इज आर्टिफिशियल हायब्रिडायझेशन? आर्टिफिशियल हायब्रिडायझेशन इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर क्रॉप इम्प्रूव्हमेंट प्रोग्रॅम अँड ड्यू टू क्रॉप इम्प्रूव्हमेंट प्रोग्रॅम ओनली डिझायर्ड हायब्रिड व्हरायटीज आर प्रोड्युस्ड. दीज डिझायर्ड हायब्रिड व्हरायटीज आर प्रोड्युस्ड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ स्पेशल टेक्निक्स दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ ब्रीडिंग टेक्निक्स असं त्याला म्हटलं जातं. देअरफॉर इन केस ऑफ ब्रीडिंग प्रोग्रॅम्स इट लीड्स टू इमॅस्क्युलेशन, बॅगिंग अँड टॅगिंग. आता पुस्तकामध्ये आपल्या हायब्रिडायझेशनच्या टेक्निक इमॅस्क्युलेशन म्हणा बॅगिंग म्हणा डिटेलमध्ये दिलेल्या नाही आहेत, तरी सुद्धा आज आपण परत एकदा थोडंसं बघणार आहे. इन आर्टिफिशियल हायब्रिडायझेशन देर इज अ अप्रोच टुवर्ड्स अ क्रॉप इम्प्रूव्हमेंट. ड्यू टू क्रॉप इम्प्रूव्हमेंट हायब्रिड व्हरायटीज आर फॉर्म्ड विथ द हेल्प ऑफ प्लांट ब्रीडर्स. इट इन्क्लूड इमॅस्क्युलेशन, बॅगिंग अँड टॅगिंग. What is emasculation? Removal of stamen from bisexual flower before anthesis is called as a emasculation. Such a emasculated flower is covered with thin polythene bag is called as a bagging. हे काय मेन प्रोसेसेस आपल्याला डिटेलमध्ये ह्यावर्षी बघायची नाही आहेत त्या. दे स्टार्ट विथ अबाउट द डबल फर्टिलायझेशन इन अँजिओस्पर्म.